How to read a nutritional label.
Hi, I'm Rohan.
I'm Atul.
And I'm Ali.
This video is brought to you by Alexian Brothers Hospital, Margaret, Mead Junior High, and the Rotary Preps of Schaumburg. Reading labels can be confusing, so we are here to help. You can usually find a nutritional label on the back of a food item. At the top of the label, there is a serving size.
This part of the label tells us the amount of food we are supposed to eat at one time.
It also has the total amount of servings in the box. It's the most important because it gives information on how much we should eat in one serving.
Calories. Under the serving size, we can find the calories section.
It contains the calories per serving.
And the total amount of calories in the box. This may vary since this only applies to containers with one serving.
Nutrients to be cautious about. In the middle of the label are fats and sodium.
This contains nutrients such as saturated fat, sodium, and cholesterol.
It also displays the amount of these nutrients.
Healthy nutrients. The opposite of these limited nutrients are nutrients that you should have.
These are vitamins such as vitamin A, C, calcium, and iron.
It also has a percentage of these nutrients per serving.
Daily value percentages. To the side of the nutrients are percentages that describe the amount of these nutrients in a serving.
This shows you how many of each nutrient you need.
This number may vary depending on the amount of calories that you need to intake.
With the highest being 20% and the lowest being 5%.
The lowest section is known as the footnote.
This informs us how many nutrients you should intake.
This number may vary depending on the amount of calories that you need.
Industrial trickery. Sometimes the number of calories listed on the box can be deceiving.
What most companies do is only advertise the calories per serving, but most boxes have more than one serving.
But that makes the public think that it's the amount of calories per container.
That's all for today.
Goodbye.
Jason, what is that in your hand? Is that a frisbee?
Oh no, this isn't a frisbee. This is a portion plate.
Well, what is a portion plate?
The portion plate is new government guidelines to demonstrate on the healthy quantity of different foods.
Your plate should be split up into four of these portions. Two of them should be fruits and vegetables, and the other two should be proteins and whole grains.
You should also eat 2 cups of fruit.
Well, what counts as a cup for that?
1 cup of raw or cooked fruit, 100% fruit juice, or 1/2 cup of dried fruit. You should also eat 2.5 cups of vegetables.
Also, for protein, you should eat approximately 55 grams, and for grains, you should eat 6 ounces of whole grains per day. Make half your grains whole grains.
What counts as an ounce for that?
1 slice of bread, 1/2 cup of cooked rice, and cereal or pasta, and 1 ounce of ready-to-eat cereal.
You should also get 3 cups of dairy each day.
Well, what counts as a cup for dairy?
1 cup of milk, yogurt, or fortified soy milk. 1/2 ounces of natural or 2 ounces processed cheese.
You should also make sure you eat 5.5 ounces of protein every day.
Choose lean meats and ground beef that are at least 90% lean. Trim or drain fat from meat and remove skin from poultry to cut fat and calories.
Well, what counts as an ounce?
1 ounce of lean meat, poultry, or fish. 1 egg. 1 tablespoon of peanut butter, and 1/2 ounce nuts or seeds, and 1/4 cup of beans.
A whole grain breakfast will keep you full longer, so you stay focused throughout the day.
Some grains you can eat would be whole grain cereal, bread, or pancakes. Choose foods that have 100% whole wheat or 100% whole grain. For example, mini wheat cereal or whole wheat bread.
Well, like I said before, make half your grains whole grains. Whole grains help reduce more weight and body fat compared to refined grain. Sad news, that's a wrap for us today, but you know what to do. Remember to step up to the plate, the portion plate.
Proteins are the building blocks of life. The body requires protein to repair and maintain itself.
It is an absolute requirement for sustaining a healthy and proper life.
All protein will help you lose fat and build muscle.
Protein keeps the body healthy by reducing diseases and prevents someone from becoming fatigued easily by producing stamina and energy.
Protein is a major part of the skin, muscles, organs, and glands.
Some foods that are high in protein are peanut butter, canned beef, canned chicken, and canned light tuna.
Other foods that contain high protein are kidney beans or any other beans, canned beef stew, or any type of Chef Boyardee.
You need enough protein on a daily basis to live a healthy life.
But you can't consume too much protein or else it will result in weight gain.
Protein also helps with weight loss if you consume the right amount of protein.
This is how protein helps you lose weight. First, it builds muscle and helps your body preserve muscle that then helps burn fat.
Second, it also helps with weight loss by keeping you full, because out of fat and carbs, it is by far the most filling.
Third, if you eat enough protein on a daily basis, your body will burn more calories.
This is why protein is important and should be consumed on a daily basis.
Ever been at the grocery store and not know what to buy? Or you buy too many things that you really don't need? Well, then make a grocery list. Here are some ways to save time and money at the grocery store.
When you go to the grocery store, make a list of all the things that you need for a certain period of time. This will help you stay on a budget and not overspend.
Also, don't shop when you're hungry, because that's when you're more likely to make purchases on less nutritious items that cost more.
Organize your list into sections according to the area of the supermarket. This cuts down the number of times and passes you need to make.
Buy on sale and in bulk when you're cruising down the aisle for sales on the shelf, stable items, or products used regularly is a great way to save money. However, but larger quantities only if you have space to store food and use the food before it spoils.
You can use coupons and reward cards to Sunday paper inserts anywhere from $50 to $75 worth of coupons in them. Clipping coupons or printing them from websites can save you 10 to 50% on your grocery bill.
You can also consider joining your supermarket shoppers club. Not only will you can enjoy specials, but you may also receive additional coupons for items you regularly purchase, printed on the back of receipts.
You can also compare unit prices. Use the unit prices to compare national brands with store and generic brands, or bulk and economy sizes with every single serve and regular size packages. Many stores show the unit price on the shelf tag.
You can shop seasonally and locally. Fresh produce often costs less when it's in season and has less distance to travel. Visit a local farmer's market or join a produce club to take advantage of seasonal fruits and veggies.
You can also buy store brands. The Food Marketing Institute reports 56% of shoppers say that they are economizing by buying store brand products, and it saves them so much more money. Private label brands are often 15 to 20% less expensive than their national brand counterparts, while the quality of the food may match the national brand.
These are all some great ways to save time and money at the grocery store.
Hey, we're here to talk to you about whole grains. It's important to make at least half of your grains whole grains.
Wait, what are whole grains?
Whole grains are unrefined grains that haven't had their bran and germ removed by milling.
Oh, well, what makes them so important?
Well, grains are naturally low in fat and high in fiber, which means they're really good for you. Plenty of grains can even lower the risk of heart disease, diabetes, and certain kinds of cancer. Hey, do you know some foods with whole grains?
Of course. Bread, pasta, oatmeal, cereal, flour, cornmeal, and rice. Rice is very important when you're sick because it helps your immune system. The best type of rice to get with whole grain is brown rice.
Yeah, and you could get all of those things at almost every grocery store.
Right, and for example, you could go look for whole grain noodles at your closest supermarket. Do you know any other good food labels to look for?
Yeah, brown rice, buckwheat, bulgur, millet, oatmeal, rolled oats, whole grain barley, whole grain sorghum, whole oats, whole rye, whole wheat, and wild rice. Do you know how to make pasta healthy?
Getting whole grain noodles at your closest grocery store. Tomatoes are also really healthy for your whole grain diet.
So to make your diet healthier, try eating more whole grain foods.
Hi, my name is Ethan.
I'm James.
And I'm Rohan. Have you ever eaten a donut and felt like you were eating air?
When I finish a bag of chips, I could eat two more.
To change that, here are some healthy snacks that will fill you up.
To start off, something that will fill you up is nuts. Mostly all types of nuts will fill you up.
Pecans, walnuts, pistachios, and cashews.
Nuts contain healthy unsaturated fat combined with protein to help keep you satisfied.
Nuts average about 7 calories per nut, so a small handful of nuts will be perfect for a great snack.
Another great satisfying food is beans.
The fiber found in beans makes them longer to digest.
You can put beans in chilies, soups, stews, dips, salsas, or burritos. Toss a handful on salad or a tasty pasta dish.
All these healthy foods will fill you up and will keep you from overeating.
We all know that some days you're tired and there's just not enough time to make a home-cooked meal and you have to get your kids food in a jiffy.
That's why you go out to fast food joints sometimes to get food for your family.
But just because it's fast food doesn't mean it has to be unhealthy.
Yeah, that's why Nick and I are going to reveal some healthy tips on fast food options.
At most of the fast food restaurants, you know that all they advertise is their burgers and their other most calorie-filled foods. But instead of getting those, even though they look good, you can get healthier foods that taste just as good.
For example, instead of getting a cheeseburger with fries and a Coke, you could get a grilled chicken wrap or other grilled chicken options. Instead of getting fried chicken, get grilled chicken at restaurants. Also, you could get salad instead of fries for your side dish.
Speaking of salads, we're now going to turn it over to Taha, our salad expert, to learn how to get a healthy salad.
You all probably think that all salads are healthy, but really, some are unhealthy. Salads loaded with fatty dressings and calorie-packed toppings are unhealthy.
That's why when you are selecting a salad, make sure the one you select is not only tasty, but also nutritious. In addition, when you order, ask for a light dressing and ask them to put the dressing on the side. When you put the dressing on the salad, remember that it is unnecessary to use the whole packet.
When they ask for what toppings you want in your salad, think of the colors of the rainbow. Red tomatoes, orange carrots, yellow peppers, green fresh lettuce, blueberries, and purple cabbage. Also, you can put low-fat croutons on your salad, but don't overdo on them. Thinking of all these salads probably makes you thirsty. So let's kick it over to our drink expert, Nick.
When you order some food, you probably need a drink so you don't become parched. But you don't need to order an extra-large soda to quench your thirst.
Instead, order a medium drink, and as an alternative, filling a soda or other sugary beverages, fill with water or unsweetened iced tea. Sodas have loads of sugar, and it makes you thirstier because of all the sodium the drink contains.
As you can see, fast food doesn't have to be unhealthy. Can be nutritious and healthy.
Just remember to make smart choices when ordering fast food and you will lead a healthy life.
There are many healthy substitutions for unhealthy foods to help you make healthier choices. Here are a few.
After school, when you feel like having chips and salsa, eat vegetables and ranch instead. Water is always a better substitution for soda because it doesn't have any sugar and it's calorie free. A piece of fruit is healthier than cookies because it contains healthy amounts of sugar.
Granola bars are a better choice than candy bars because they have healthy nutrients. Make sure to check the back label and make sure your granola bar is under 200 calories. Drinking milk instead of juice gives you more calcium and less sugar. If you're going to drink juice, water it down a bit so it makes it a little healthier. Frozen yogurt is always a good substitution for having a few scoops of ice cream.
These things will fill you up so you aren't snacking as often as you would with your unhealthier foods.
Now, here's a recipe for a healthy yogurt parfait. First, use a clear cup so you can see your ingredients. What you'll need is a cup of your favorite brand of low-fat yogurt, some berries of your choice, and some granola. Here's how to make it. Add yogurt into the cup, then berries, then alternate between fruit and yogurt layers. Then, top the parfait with granola. Use a smaller cup if you want to go for a snack-sized portion. Enjoy this healthy recipe. This recipe is just one of the many ways you can make healthy choices every day.
Ugh, my parents keep on telling me that I need to get calcium, but I don't like milk.
Well, Alexian says it takes 15 to 20 times to get to like something, so you should keep trying. But I get it. I can't eat or drink dairy products like milk, but I still get my dose of calcium. There's some foods out there that have a great source of calcium, even if they aren't a dairy product.
Like what?
Let's sit. Like I was saying, soy milk is a very good source of calcium. When we first found out I was allergic to dairy, I hated soy milk. But now I know that calcium is very important. Calcium is what builds your bone structure. You need healthy bones if you want to be strong and healthy.
Oh, I didn't know that soy milk had calcium. What other foods have calcium?
Well, cheese has some, but if you're allergic to dairy like me, you can eat broccoli, almonds, white beans, baked beans, and of course everyone's favorite, spinach.
Sorry to peek on your conversation, everything. My sister is also allergic to dairy, but she doesn't really like healthy foods. As a matter of fact, she's a bit of a sweet tooth. What should I do?
Well, if she likes sweet foods, she can use soy or almond milk, which is dairy-free. That is especially made for people like your sister. So if you want to make brownies or a delicious dessert, you can use dairy-free milk to make it.
That's so cool! But we do have to convince her to eat something more healthier. What is something that's healthy and sweet?
Well, fruits and vegetables are obviously foods with calcium. And you can also make a delicious fruit smoothie, like with these apples, and adding a little sugar in it, but don't go overboard. That way, it can be sweet and healthy.
Wow, I'm gonna go home and make something yummy and healthy.
And you should too!
Look at my muscles. How do you think I became big and strong? From sitting around eating a bag of chips? Actually, sorta. But that's besides the point. Anyway, do you like water? I do, because it helps me recover after a hard workout. Instead of drinking Gatorade or an energy drink, I drink water because it is proven to be the best for you. Remember to drink water with every meal. Water is not only nourishing, it has zero calories.
Take it to the river. Water is home to all of the awesome fish. Now, say you had a big cheesy sandwich. When it needs to come out from your body, it might be tough. Take a little sip of this nice stuff, water, and boom, done, problem gone. Also, I know that normal people don't want kidney stones, so drink water and you will most likely not get them. Water is one of the best ways to keep your internal organs healthy and keep you going.
Sand at the beach. The best choice if you are dehydrated is to drink a bottle of water. Now, isn't that refreshing? Water is proven to prevent tooth decay if you love your white teeth. It also keeps my skin looking good. You should always carry a bottle of water with you, wherever you go. Water can help you maintain your calories. It keeps your body looking good and healthy.
Today we're going to present how to make a simple and delicious recipe of green beans and macaroni and cheese. One is fast and simple and also healthier.
First, you need a can of green beans, frozen so it comes crunchy.
Also, you need a tablespoon of butter and medium white flour. Also, get 1 teaspoon of mustard powder if possible.
Add sea salt for taste.
1 healthy cup of low-fat milk will give you stronger bones, so add it to a list.
Don't forget to add a can of mixed vegetables so you get your daily dose per meal.
Plus, use spinach and mixed vegetables.
Finally, you should use 1 pack of whole wheat macaroni and cheese.
Now we come to the real cooking part.
Dice the beans and chop up the spinach.
Cut up the cauliflower into small pieces for now and steam the vegetables. Meanwhile, instead of wasting time, melt a small amount of butter in a medium saucepan. Add the butter into the flour, butter, and sea salt for a real good sauce.
Stir the sauce in a cup of milk and whisk over low-medium heat till you get a thickened texture. Add white pepper to season if desired.
Pour the beans and sauce over the mac and add the steamed vegetables on the macaroni and beans too.
Add salt for taste. Also add cheese, which will stick on the breadcrumbs. This recipe has low calories and less fat, unlike other recipes.
Take in the healthy fiber and protein for lots of nutrients and get your calcium from the cheese. Enjoy this healthy, fast, simple, and delicious recipe.
Hi, I'm Chris, and we have some breaking news. Americans are overdoing the amount of sodium they consume. But how do we reduce that amount? That's why we are here today to discuss how to reduce sodium from everyday canned foods.
Did you know sodium is used to regulate blood pressure and the volume of blood vessels? If you eat too much, your blood pressure will get too high and you may have serious health issues. Most people consume their sodium as salt. Americans have a problem with consuming too much of it. If you're like an average American, then you could get excess salt from unexpected sources like canned vegetables.
We have the famous chef Nate DiMaria here to demonstrate a simple two-step process of getting rid of a majority of the sodium in the canned foods you eat every day.
Here's our first step. Try to look for a reduced or low sodium label on the canned vegetables when you're shopping at the grocery store.
Step 2. Put the vegetables in a strainer and wash them. Then keep them in water for 2 to 3 minutes. Drain away all the excess liquid which contains most of the sodium.
This is one way to reduce your daily sodium from canned foods. Remember, too much sodium causes high blood pressure which affects your heart. So please use these steps to improve your health.
Most people are bothered by how to get enough exercise.
If you want to get exercise but don't have time to go to the gym, here are some fast tips to get a workout fast.
If you do stretches for 30 minutes a day, you can burn 85 calories if you weigh about 150 pounds. Stretching also makes you flexible and tones your muscles.
Stepping in place or just walking up and down the stairs for 10 to 15 minutes is a very easy way to maintain a healthy weight and burn surplus calories.
Doing about 50 push-ups a day burns off excess fat, and when you're doing a push-up, you are holding up 70% of your weight on your arms. Doing a brisk walk around after lunch at work or just after work for 15 minutes loses 100 calories and is a very easy way to maintain a healthy weight.
Vigorous housework for 20 to 30 minutes can burn a little more than 100 calories, and because you have to clean the house on some days, this makes it an easy way to maintain a healthy weight. When in the office, if you take the stairs to your floor instead of the elevator for about 20 minutes, can burn 100 or more calories.
Drinking a glass of water before a meal would make you feel less famished because thirst can be mistaken as hunger.
If you want to maintain a healthy weight with your family outside, then you can toss a ball or go on a bike ride.
Weeding the garden, raking leaves, or even playing on a playground are fun ways to maintain a healthy weight.
Maintaining a healthy weight with your family indoors can be fun too.
Play music and dance with your family is a fun way to get moving indoors.
You can blow up balloons and play indoor volleyball.
Have a treasure hunt and see how fast everyone can find clues scattered around your house.
To do all these activities, you don't need to go out and buy a $100 pair of clothes. Just wear sweatpants, shorts, or yoga pants. For a shirt, a loose-fitting or a tight-fitting shirt. It's really up to you and what you prefer. Also, just a nice family day.
We would like to give a special thanks to Rotary Club, Alexian Brothers Hospital, and a Mead Junior High.
I got the green beans, macaroni and cheese. I got the green beans, macaroni and cheese. I got the green beans, macaroni and cheese. I got the green beans, macaroni and cheese.
Alright, Joey C, gonna show you how to break it down. You already know what's gonna go down. You buy the beans while they're crunchy. You eat this snack when you got the munchies.
Alright.
Get some butter and mustard powder.
Okay.
After eating this snack, you'll be like, I got the power. Now we come to the real cooking part.
Right.
Make a healthy choice, you'll be feeling super smart.
Let's go. Green beans, macaroni and cheese. I got the macaroni and cheese. I got the green beans, macaroni and cheese. I got the green beans, macaroni and cheese.
You get the cheese, yeah. You mix it all together, you get mac and cheese. Bro. It's a simple snack you can make anytime, and I'm not just saying this so I can rhyme. Uh-huh. The butter, the powder, the mustard, the flour. Okay. You mix it all together, it's tasting not sour. Now I'm finally done, but this rap isn't done yet. Oh. Now I'm gonna kick it to Nico, the cool cat.
When you get green beans and mac and cheese, you get crazy, you wanna jump up and shout. You know you're inside, know what it's all about. Here we go. Green macaroni and cheese. You got the green beans, macaroni and cheese. I got the green beans, macaroni and cheese. I got the green beans, macaroni and cheese. I'm out.
can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world. You can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up. You can beat the clock. You can move a mountain. You can break rocks. You can be a master. Don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself.
Standing in the hall of fame. And the world's gonna know your name.
Yeah.
Cause you burn with the brightest flame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name.
Yeah.
And you'll be on the walls of the Hall of Fame.
You can go the distance, you can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile. You could be the hero, you could get the gold. Breaking all the records he thought never could be broke.
Yeah.